chapter number 5, verse 39 through. Mark, chapter number 5, 39 through 42. Now, Jesus had come out of the boat and to go to the other side. You may be seated. To go to the other side. When you are confronted with the enemy, you got to have the power to confront the enemy.
Come on now.
Jesus stepped out of the boat, and when he stepped out of the boat, there was a man that met him, and he was possessed with the devil. He was possessed with demons. He was possessed with an evil spirit. And Jesus said, come out of that man. Now I want to focus on Mark chapter number 5, 39 through 42. I will continue this message on Sunday, but a different text. Mark chapter number 5, 39 through 42. And when Jesus had been confronted by the man, and Jesus took and cast the devil out of the man, and when he cast the demons out of the man, he says, what is your name? He says, my name is Legion. I got many. Now, in order to do what Jesus had to do, the first thing we must do is arise. I want to use the subject, arise. Y'all hear me say arise? Stay alive and arise. So Jesus was confronted with an enemy, and then when Jesus cast the demon out of the man, Jesus went a little bit further. Sometimes when you may have something to do or a work to do, something will try to stop the original progress where you are trying to do. Sometimes there are things that will confront you and cause you to be sidestepped. But remember what Jesus was on his way to do. Jesus was on his way to heal a young girl about 12 years old. The Bible says that she was a damsel about 12 years old. Now 12 is a number that is significant when being an adult. In the Jewish religion, a young man became a male when he got into the age of 12 years old. Now hear me, young people, just because you're 12 doesn't mean you have the ability to sass your parents out and talk back to them and do the whole thing. He said, children, he said, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Not only that, but obey your parents because your days may be long upon the face of this earth. So sometimes we look at 12 as being a time when we can get smart and time that we don't have to do anything. We don't have to listen to anyone, but I come to tell you the devil is a liar. So this particular girl was about 12 years old. The Bible says that Jairus' daughter, they sent out to say, go find Jesus. So Jairus' daughter was sick. And by the time he found Jesus, he said Jesus was on his way to her house. Now keep in mind that Jesus do not have to come to your house in order to get results from him. Yes. He can just speak the word that he did the centurion, yes, and his servant can be healed. But we find out here that Jesus was going his way to the house of Jairus' daughter, 12 years old. Young people, just because you think you're 12, you have a long life to live, your life is not predicated on your youth or how young you are. The Bible says a man's life does not consist in the abundance of the things which he possess. It's not about your possession, what you got. That's not what life is all about. James says, what is your life? And it is, it even as a vapor that appeared for a little while and then vanished. In other words, life is not promising you a long time. Life is not given to you that you may live out to be 80 and 90 years old. Methuselah lived 969 years, but guess what? The Bible said, and he died. Come on, somebody.
Come on now.
But Hercules and all those lived. Okay, all those ages, and they died. But Jesus, he never died. He got up out of the grave, didn't have to die anymore. So, young people, what I'm saying, hear what I'm saying, that it's time for you to arise out of what you're doing and begin to do what God has labeled you to do. True Life, Pentecostal, Holiness Church, we've been sleeping too long. It's time for us to arise.
Oh, yeah. Come on,
we've been doing too many things, and we're not doing the right thing. I come to tell you, the Bible tells us that Jesus is on his way to heal the young girl who had been sick. And on his way, there was a woman that had an issue of blood for 12 long years. And the Bible said on his way that Jesus had to stop by and heal her, because when she touched the hem of his garment, she became whole. What are you saying, brother preacher? I'm saying Jesus on his way to Jairus' house to heal his daughter or touch his daughter that was sick. Someone in the midst, someone in the process got healed on his way going to do another job.
Come on now.
Sometimes, beloved of God, when we are doing things for God and when we're on our way doing things for God, God will use us in another way in order to accomplish his purpose. The woman that had been there had an issue for 12 long years, and the Bible said, and she was healed, and some of the virtue of Jesus went out, and Jesus healed her. And by the time word had came to Jesus, note that sometimes distraction will cause you to not be able to accomplish what you need to accomplish. Because when Jesus had gotten word that Lazarus had been sick, Jesus stayed for a couple more days later. And by the time he got to the house of Mary and Martha, Lazarus was dead. What are you saying, brother preacher? I'm saying that Jesus knew that he had to do the work of the Father. Stay with me. And the Bible said that he was on his way to Jairus' house to heal, and then in the meantime, the young girl was sick. Somebody said sick.
Sick.
Sick. Now 6 years old, sick, S-I-C-K, she was sick. And by the time Jesus got there, Lord have mercy, she was dead. And then there was grieving, and there was grieving, there was crying, and there was a turmoil that was going on because the young girl had died. Now, no one told Jesus if you had came a little earlier, she would not have died. But Mary and Martha, they said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But Jesus knew what he had to do and knew what needed to be done in order to accomplish the will of God. Someone got healed, a woman got healed of the issue of blood. For 12 long years, she'd been waiting as Jesus was on his way. And then when he got to the house, there was crying, there was weeping because this little girl had died. And because she had died, the parents was upset. The parents was crying. They was weeping because they lost their loved one. It is nothing unusual to be able to cry tears because you lost your loved one. But Jesus told them in a prophetic word, he said, the young girl is not dead, but she is sleeping. Come on, somebody. And he said, I must go in here and awake her out of the sleep. Come on, somebody. True Life is not dead, but True Life needs to be awake out of their sleep. True Life is not dead, but needs to be awake. Hallelujah. tonight have been sleeping for a long time. 2015, you slept a long time, but the Lord gave me this message to tell them it's time for you to arise. When you get ready to arise, then see what happens. When you look at arise, that means to get out of your comfort zone. When it means to arise, it means to change your position. You've been laying down too long, and your position has got to change. When you look at rise, blessed be the name of God, you must learn how to be able to move in a different direction. When you have been arise, it means that you are ready to extend beyond the horizon. Oh, you've been doing some things that are not contrary to the word of God. You've been doing some things that have altered your path and caused you to sleep. But he comes and tells us to arise. He tells the young girl, he said, arise, blessed be the name of God. He said, arise, damsel. I say to the church, True Life Pentecostal, Holiness Church, it's time for us to arise. Arise out of what we've been doing. Oh, you've been napping, you've been sleeping, you've been napping, cat napping. But it's time to arise out of what we've been doing. Because God has a greater work for us to do. God has a greater anointing. He has a greater vision for us to do. He has a greater dimension for us to do. But we cannot do it until the Lord have already spoken to us and tell us to arise, hallelujah. When we arise, hallelujah, we get out of a laying down position and we move into a stand up position. Come on, somebody. We've been laying down on the word of God. But the Bible tells us to stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. We've been laying down and laying down too long. We've been sleeping. Come on, somebody. We've been sleeping in Bible class. We've been sleeping in Sunday school. We've been sleeping in prayer meetings. Blessed be the name of God. And when we call prayer, seem like nobody want to come to prayer. And when we fall on our knees, seem like nobody want to pray anymore. Nobody want to fast and pray anymore. So the Lord tell me to tell you, Church of the Living God, it's time for us to arise. It's time for us to arise. Let it be the name of God. Because greater works are, hallelujah. I know they put you down. Blessed be the name of God. I'm going to preach this. I know they told you. They told you you're dead. They told you you're dead. There's no power in you. There's no anointing in you. There's nothing in you. But I come to tell you, you're not dead, hallelujah. You're just laying asleep. And it takes the master to wake us up out of our sleep. It takes Jesus to wake us up out of our sleep. It takes Jesus to touch a little girl and tell her, deaf soul, arise, get up, hallelujah. What you've been doing, get up, hallelujah. What you've been doing, it's not good enough. What you've been doing, it's not good enough. True Light is not good enough. It's not good enough. I come to tell you, you're not fooling God. I'm not fooling God. Because God sees you. He knows what you're going through. I know you don't want to do it, but I come to tell you, you got to do it. If you want to be saved, you got to do it. Did you want to go back with God? He told me to tell you to arise, hallelujah. Get out of the fixed position. Get up ready to do some work. Ready to build, hallelujah. Have your hammer in your hand. Come on, come by. The work is too great to let just a few do it. The work is too great for you to sit down by the willow tree and hang your heart and say, I'm not going to sing God praises. The foundation needs to be structured. Come on, somebody. The kingdom needs to be built. Come on, you are the laborers. You are the laborers. The Bible says that we are laborers together. I can't do it by myself. I need your help. That's why I need true light. So rise and say, let's build. Hallelujah. Come on, rise. Let's get the job done. Let's get the job done. Come on, somebody. We got to get the job done. We got to work together. We got to work together. Because we are laboring together. We can't sleep on God. He said, rise. Get up from here, oh, you sleeper. Come on, somebody. You can't do God's work. Then you're sleeping. Get up, preaching. Hallelujah. Jonah was down in the bottom of the boat, fast asleep. Now he had a work to do. God told him to go down to Nineveh and preach to Nineveh. Jonah did not want to go to Nineveh because Jonah was a racist. Some of y'all are racist. Some of y'all don't want to go to the Aram. Some of y'all don't want to go. Then don't you realize that he is the Aram? The Muslims are being saved and filled with the Holy Ghost. They escaped in Syria because of the danger, and they're going into countries that are Christians. That's going to turn them on unto Christianity because their love that you have for the people of God. He's going to bless God. Going to bless God. Don't you know that it was Syria? It was in Damascus that Paul had his experience with God. He was filled with the Holy Ghost. He was knocked off the donkey and said, who is thou, Lord? He said, I'm Jesus. Don't you know that God is the only one that authorized to speak from heaven? When he told there, well, told Moses on the backside, he said, Moses said, what is your name? He said, my name is I Am. I'm Ekay, Asher, Ekay. I'm the God. I am who I am. I am why I am. I am what I am. I am where I will be. Come on, somebody. And so in the New Testament, Jesus spoke from the heavens. He said, this is my beloved son. In the New Testament, when the dove came down, this is my son, in whom I am well pleased. And then when Paul was on his way to down Damascus, God touched him. There are people that need to be in touch. You got to rise. But Jonah did not want to go.
Hallelujah.
And preach to Nineveh. Because Jonah didn't want to go. So Jonah knew that if I preach God's word, these people can be saved. Come on, somebody. Death and life is in the power of your tongue. You got to rise that you may be able to bring life to a dying soul. Because you are the light bearer. You are the light of the world. You are a city that sits on the hill. Don't hide your light. Blessed be the name of God. I come to tell you, Jonah didn't want to preach to him because he knows they're going to change. But I'm going to tell you, Pastor Hall, don't mind preaching to you if it's going to cause you to change. I don't mind preaching. But Jonah said, I'm not going to preach. But there he was, sleeping in the bottom of the boat. Some of us have got too comfortable. We're sleeping on God. We're sleeping on his word. We're sleeping on his praise. We done got too comfortable. But he said, he told Jonah, wake up, old thou sleeper. Come on, begin to pray to your God. You got to rise from here. Pray to your God. And Jonah rose. And the Bible said, they threw him overboard. And the fish, hallelujah, put him on dry land. And when he got on dry land, Jonah, hallelujah, he arose and went and did what God told him to do. You got to rise and do what God told you to do. Come on, somebody. And it's a base you to sing the song. Whatever the Lord tell you to do, he said, I'm going to do what the Lord say to. Whatever God tell you to do, I'm going to do it. So I want you to rise. 2016, I want you to rise and let's build, hallelujah. I want you to rise and let's fortify our effort. Arise and let's get the job done. Come on, somebody. You are the workers. get up from their position. We spiritually sleep too much, and we naturally sleep too much. Naturally sleep too much. Some of y'all sleeping 10, 11 hours a day. Think nothing of it. Jesus got up early in the morning, said, I must be about my Father's business. Got no time to be playing. Got to be about his Father's business.
Come on. Come on.
Even though you look dead, there's a revitalization that's going to take place. Even though you in the fixed position like you're dead, Jesus that gave the word says, Talitha Kuma, damsel, arise. Arise.
Arise.
She sat up, and what did she do? Gave her something to eat. Okay, watch this. They gave her something to eat. When you arise, then you need to be fed. What are you going to be fed? You're going to be fed on the nothing but the word of God.
Oh, yes.
She rose up and was fed on the natural food. But true life, we got to rise up and be fed on the spiritual food.
Yes, sir, Pastor.
The spiritual food that God's going to give us through his ministers.
Yes, sir.
Somebody said, give it through you, not necessarily through me. He can, but his ministers. He have given the word to his ministers. So as a minister, minister to you, whether that is me, Minister Troy, Bishop Boland, Bishop Roberts, or anybody, you're supposed to give your attention to the word of God. You're supposed to listen to the word of God and hear. And then when you hear, you're supposed to respond to the word of God.
Oh, yes.
Stand up! Some of y'all still sit. I did that on purpose. To see whether or not you would respond to the word of God. Now some of y'all was really late getting up. Really late. I don't know if because you're older. Okay? My reason for that is that when the word is being spoken, you respond.